will be on YouTube.
How many of you have tried to learn a second language? You know, French, Spanish, high school, college. A lot of you guys aren't living in the lines, but you know, me personally, I tried to learn Spanish. I kind of failed through in high school and even in college and all that kind of stuff. But I was so excited when I got my tickets to go to Costa Rica. I was going to land and, you know, I was going to finally use Spanish, right? First thing someone said to me, I was like, I'm feeling like this. I had no idea. It was a culture shock, right? You don't know what you're really going to say back. You're just like, what the hell just happened? So for the most part, at this stage, the reason why is because you haven't been immersed in the language. And now I'm going to explain, kind of stepping back a little bit. If you want to take a look at this at a global scale, we're looking at 300 million people in China trying to learn English, and there's 12.7 million unemployed native English speakers in the U.S. area alone. So how do we actually connect these people? That's what HelloBuy is all about. We want to be a marketplace where people can practice their language skills, English skills, with real native speakers. I'm going to tell you a little bit about who these people really are. Who's the demand, who are one that have the demand people, you know, have supply, obviously. Right over there is Kevin. Kevin, like I said, he's my cousin. He's a college student. You know, speaks English, put a lot of money. He's for college. He needs, extra 10 to 15 bucks an hour every day. And then there is my real aunt. I found a picture of her. She's even there. So she lives in Hong Kong, upper class. Auntie Becky's got two kids. And she is a tiger mom. She is certified insane by our standards. she actually did spend $250,000 while her son was 2 years old, just to get him at the top of the waiting list. They call it a deputy to actually get into the school, into the school. So they take this stuff seriously. And Auntie Becky's perfect peer is Kevin. Native speaker. The thing is, how is she going to find these guys, on day one? Well, she can't. They're going to be local speakers that don't get the idioms, they have an accent, all that stuff. And pricing-wise, it's $30 to $70 per hour per child. Really expensive. Definitely cost prohibitive. It's a tent. I guess we're going to show it off right now, right? I'll show them to you. So the setup is just really what we're going to do. But the setup process is super quick in terms of choosing your native language.
Say we click on English, and we want to learn English, and we're going to get access, blah, 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 go to the next one more page. So the idea here is that as a person trying to find an English tutor, this is a very low barrier entry type of way. I don't have to discover so much anymore at this point. Trust is almost immediate. I know who's better, who's going to be fit for me. We have certified, elite, the whole kind of like a Yelp type of stuff, but we score them. And that's part of the business model. We have native speakers, we score them. And the other thing is, we don't have to do any type of scheduling. That's the other thing. What if this tutor is perfect and only does it on Sundays? Well, go ahead. These people are online at this point. They click on the green button, and now there's more than just video interaction. There's still immersion. We have topics that they can talk about: sports, food, movies, media, games they can try to play. In this case, they're playing like a charades type of thing, right? Some chat. If there needs to be some type of level of help, quizzes. You see some recordings, timings, and a couple other functionality we kind of mocked up here. So what did we really solve with this type of product? Well, trust, right? You know exactly what you're, it's not like a flyer where you don't know what this person can really truly do. Native speakers as opposed to local speakers, they get the idioms, the accent, and all that stuff. Scheduling, you can start speaking immediately, so it's very flexible in that regard. And payment. Kevin actually works for $10 an hour at Starbucks, and with the pricing, 10 to 15, it's something that he would do. Something that's even more convenient for him to do. So with that said, our business model, tutors set their own prices, super simple here. We take 10% of every transaction. We expect the median to be around 12, which is kind of what, I guess, what you earn in Starbucks anyway. Next slide, please. Obviously, this can scale to a different, many different countries, and that's part of the, I think, the larger scope of this is, if you do Hong Kong to with the U.S., let's take that business model, take that process, and scale it to all of it and reiterate all across the board. Next one is competitors. So we had a couple competitors: Language Spirit, Verbling. These guys were expensive. I'm running out of time. Dribbling was like super weird. I didn't know what the heck was going on. There's no dominant solution, that's to put it that way, to really learn English for all those people that are Tiger moms especially.
There's more casual conversational level, and these